There's really two things that Sumatran tigers need. The first thing is habitat. They need enough places and big enough places. And secondly, they need poaching controlled. That's poaching of tigers, but also poaching of their prey and the whole wildlife trade network that drives all that.
Sumatran tigers have survived in Indonesia for thousands of years. Adapting to changing conditions, they've managed to keep themselves alive. But humans destroying their habitat may be one thing they cannot survive. In the wild, Sumatran tigers feed mainly on wild boar and deer. Eating up to 35 kilograms of meat in one go and making a meal last for days. When full, it will cover the carcass and return only when it is hungry again. But tigers in this facility will never hunt in the wild again. Although spared potential death from poachers, these tigers will have to live out their lives in captivity.
Kalau misalkan ini emang dia habitatnya di hutan, emang dia lebih baik di hutan. Tapi namanya harimau ini harimau bermasalah. Jadi mau nggak mau kita selamatkan di breeding center ini daripada mereka tangkap sama penduduk di sana terus mereka dibunuh karena apa nilai ini sangat tinggi sekali kan apa dari kulitnya dari taringnya dari kukunya.
40 years ago, this center had an influx of conflict tigers and no forest to release them in. Taman Safari staff teamed up with other Indonesian zoos to start breeding these critically endangered tigers to help keep the species alive. Today, it's one of the largest breeding facilities for Sumatran tigers in the world. Tony Sumampau, the director of the center, is the man behind the breeding program. Keeping wild tigers behind bars and breeding them is controversial, but this tiger facility could hold the future of the species in its gene bank.
Not everybody agree with what we have done here. The reason is because they think that the tiger should be in the wild all the time. If we have a nice habitat for them to release, it would be fine. But nowadays, it's difficult to have a big habitat for releasing the tigers, especially the problem tiger, man-eater tiger. So we put them in the breeding environment so we can breed them, so we can have a very strong gene pool of the Sumatran tigers.
Indonesia has already lost two tiger subspecies, the Balinese and the Javanese tigers. Both species could have been kept alive in zoos with the help of a breeding program. It's an irony, but with less than 400 in the wild, life behind bars for these Sumatran tigers could help the survival of the entire species. Dr. Johanna, who treated Salma, the young female, is responsible for all the tigers at the center. At the moment, Taman Safari has 33 Sumatran tigers to its name, and that number is about to increase. One of the tigers, Desi, is 2 months pregnant.
Desi ini lagi bunting.
Terus vitamin. Jangan lupa vitamin kalsana D seperti biasa. 4 tablet. Terus multivitamin lewat makan.
A tiger's gestation period is around 100 days. So Daisy has another month before she gives birth. A new birth is a tense time here, and the staff will be on call 24/7.
Tapi kondisinya sih sekarang dia kondisinya bagus ya. Puntingnya juga sudah mulai kelihatan membesar, perutnya juga sedikit sudah mulai membesar. Nafsu makannya bagus. Secara umum kondisinya sih bagus.
Arsiad has a personal interest in making sure Desi has a smooth pregnancy.
Saya favorit saya ya Desi itu, yang betina itu. Mungkin dia apa, nggak terlalu agresif seperti yang lain. Tetap kita juga harus waspada, tapi saya paling senang lihat si Desi itu. Senang aja saya ngelihat dia ini. Karena apa ya, dia bisa apa, bikin bangga saya. Karena dia, kalau ya itu tadi, kalau misalnya dia lahirin, dia selalu ngerawat anaknya yang baik.
But breeding endangered tigers isn't easy. In the middle of her rounds, Johanna gets a worrying call about some of the newly born cubs.
Masuk, masuk. Copy, copy. Segera ke sana.
The center's newest members were born in December last year. Rejected by their mother, the two-month-old brother's survival is in the hands of Taman's dedicated team of foster parent vets. Every new birth strengthens the Sumatran tiger gene pool. Two-month-old brothers, Yuda and Wira, depend fully on their surrogate mothers, needing to be fed every 4 hours, just like a human baby. But Yuda is having trouble swallowing. If he can't get nourishment, he won't survive long.
Ih, kenapa kamu? Tanglengnya ke mana arahnya?
Dongak ke atas sama ke kiri.
Sayang, sakit ya, sakit ya. Oh iya, ini Mbak. Dia kan nggak radang. Karena nggak panas, jadi di ini aja. Dipijit rutin sehari 3 kali, pagi sore gitu. Mbak Sri sendiri yang ini. Terus paling tambah kalsium ya.
If his neck doesn't straighten out, he won't be able to eat solid food, stopping him from developing. Johanna shows the vet's assistant how to prepare extra calcium for the cub.
Si Yuda ini bermasalah dengan problem dengan muskulusnya. Kemungkinan, tapi bukan karena radang atau infeksi. Kemungkinan dulu mungkin pernah keinjak induknya atau sesuatu yang kita nggak tahu pasti. Jadi di sini harus dirawat di nursery karena harus rutin di terapi, dipijit sehari 3 kali dan dibantu dengan kalsium yang supaya mudah pemberiannya dicampur dengan susu.
They will all be keeping a close eye on Yuda.
Karena memang tugas kami menyelamatkan dia sampai bisa survive, sampai kalau bisa sampai beranak lagi.
When they're 4 months old, Wira and Yuda will be returned to the breeding center, hoping that in the future they will mate and produce a new generation of Sumatran tigers to help keep the species alive. Collecting detailed records of which tigers mate and the offspring they produce helps to keep the gene pool pure.
Hello.
And that's Dr. Ligaya Tumbelaka's job. She manages the Sumatran tiger's database and keeps all DNA samples in the center's gene bank. Each sample is vitally important.
With this gene bank, we can analyze whether certain tiger is really Sumatran tiger or not.
This stops inbreeding, which could harm the future of the species. With so few tigers left, one day more desperate measures may have to be considered.
If we think that maybe in the future the number will get lower, we need to think about certain technology. Maybe we use like a reproduction technology, like collecting sperm and then use that sperm to inseminate to the animal.
Today, Ligaya and Johanna are collecting blood from a tiger for DNA analysis. They hope to mate him, but they need to make sure he has no genetic abnormalities. It sounds like a simple process, but how do you take blood from a large adult tiger?
So this is a tiger that we are going to take the blood. Now we have this squeeze cage, so we can use this without anesthetize the animal. We will try to do it as good as possible, so it won't hurt the animal.
But squeezing a Sumatran tiger is easier said than done. They will need all the muscle available. The tiger won't want to be in the cage. They all need to be careful.
We are going to take the blood from the vein from the tail. So first we need to tourniquet the tail part. After that, we need to clean a little bit the part of the tail. Using butterfly needle, we poke the part of the tail, and then with 10 cc syringe, we will get the blood out from the vein.
The blood will be analyzed and the DNA will be recorded in the regional stud book to find a good match for this tiger to mate with. If Salma, the female in Jambi Zoo, is brought to the breeding facility, this male could be her potential mate. But her fate is still unknown.
Thank you for watching.